Would you like to learn how to make this trendy dark mode website that you're gonna see on your screen right now? Just stay in this video, because I'm gonna teach you how. Okay guys, I've seen these trendy dark mode websites popping all over Dribbble and Behance, and I would like to teach you guys how to do it. This is my approach and how to do it in Adobe XD. So without any more delay, let's just start designing. Okay guys, the result's gonna be something like this, and we're gonna try to start with a website which is in just black and white. This is gonna be in the description of the video so you can follow along. Yeah, I'm gonna duplicate this one, put it right here. Let me show you right now. I'm gonna take this black and white version of the site, and one of the things that I notice first is how to make this grid that we have in this other website. This is what we're going to start with. I'm going to try to make a square right there at the top. It doesn't have to be perfect. Let's make it 50 by 50. Let me just swap this part of the components all the way to the layers, and we're going to just create a rectangle, and we're going to use a repeat grid, and I'm just going to expand it all over the canvas, horizontal and vertically. The next step will be to fix these gaps that it has right here. We're just going to shrink it there and just, you know, remove those gaps. And we're gonna select the first square, and making sure that we select the same color that we're using right here in the design. Just gonna remove the white, and I'm gonna use the eyedropper tool, and I'm gonna try to select specifically that color, and we should have something like this. I'm gonna take this, all these squares, and I'm just gonna expand them all over the website. There we go. Something like this will be fine. I'm gonna send this all the way to the back. I'm gonna reduce the opacity for a little bit. And the next step will be to change the color of all these texts. For that, I'm gonna take this color that I have right here, which is gonna be CBCBCV. I'm gonna take that color and I'm gonna use it along the side. So I'm gonna click these two elements, I'm gonna press Command V, press Enter. I'm gonna take that color, I'm gonna add it to the color swatches. And I'm gonna do the same thing with here, with this one. And we're gonna apply this to all the elements that we have right here in the site. So apply it again to the logo and to the links right there. And at this point, I think what we should do is to increase the opacity again, and we're gonna have the new text and the grid in the background. The next step for the grid to fix this look that the grid has is we're gonna create a square on top of it. And in this square that we have right here, we're gonna make sure to pick this dark color as the base of it. So I'm gonna select the fill of the overlay, and I'm gonna put it on top of it. I'm gonna click the color and I'm gonna add it to the swatch, which is like almost a black color, like 09090B. And I'm gonna select this one again, the overlay, and I'm gonna change the mode. Instead of solid color, we're gonna use a radial gradient, and I'm gonna take that gradient all the way to the top. So what I'm planning to do is to take this radial gradient and put it from the top, and I'm gonna inverse that gradient. I'm gonna select this color, I'm gonna put it dark as well. I'm gonna take the first one and I'm gonna reduce all the opacity, and then I'm gonna try to shrink it a little, and then I'm gonna play with the shape to something like this and try to make it a little bit, you know, move it a little bit higher, something like that. Okay, and then the next step will be to take these two layers and send them all the way to the back. So Command Shift back bracket, or you know what, I'm just gonna do it a different way. I'm gonna say send to the back, so you can see it, and I'm gonna group them, and I'm gonna name this background. Once we have the background, the next step will be to recreate this part of this type of dark mode gradients, which is that they use two different colors, close to black and an outline. So I'm gonna change this color to this light gray, and I'm gonna change the fill to be a linear gradient, and it's gonna come from this side all the way to this side, or maybe really close, something like this. I'm gonna take this up like that and move it all this way, and then I'm gonna change the first color to like a really like dark, which is gonna be 2D, 3B, and 4B, and the second color is gonna be a little darker. It's gonna be almost all the way black, but it's gonna take a little bit higher, so we can create that effect that we see right there. We're gonna include a little bit of a drop shadow. We're gonna take like a 3, 3, and 15. We're gonna increase that drop shadow a little bit more. We're making sure that it's black, and we have the box, plus we have the fix in the text and everything. The next step will be the buttons that I can see. So these are these buttons that we have right here. I'm gonna teach you guys how to make this style of button, and we're gonna use the layers to start that. To make that button, I'm gonna ungroup this. I'm gonna take this. I'm gonna leave the get in touch. I'm gonna create a square on top of it. Okay, I'm gonna, the fill, it's gonna be the same as the other color that we have in this design. Yeah, so I'm sending it back so we can see the get in touch part of the button. And the next step will be to take this button. I'm gonna remove the border of it, and making sure that I have this group. I'm gonna group this and I'm gonna call this CTA, and this is gonna be your call to action. We're gonna double click the call to action, and I'm gonna select the button, and I'm gonna press Command Z, Command V. I'm gonna put a button on top of it, and this one is gonna be changed to be smaller, so 1 pixel smaller. So this is 128, we're gonna reduce 2 pixels from the top and the bottom, it's 126. And then instead of 48, we're gonna reduce 2, so it's gonna be 46, okay? I'm gonna press enter, I'm gonna select these two, and I'm gonna align them with each other. And the next step is to take this second one that is bigger, and we're gonna change the color to a little bit of a lighter color. We can go all the way to this gray color, and we're gonna reduce the opacity of this one. We're gonna create a circle. This circle, we're gonna place it without the border on top of the design. We're gonna change the color to kind of like a bluish tone in the fill, and like, let's go to the bluish. We're gonna go with the object blur, then we're gonna increase it a little bit, or reduce the opacity and change the mode to hard light. And then we're gonna move this eclipse in between these two layers like a sandwich, okay? We're gonna take this CTA and we're gonna make it, I press Command K, and we're gonna make it a component, and we're gonna add an extra state, which is gonna be a hover state. And in this hover state, I'm gonna double click the CTA. I'm gonna take this eclipse, I'm gonna increase the opacity, and I'm gonna make it bigger and expanding a little bit more like that. And we're gonna make it a little bit more potent in the colors, and it's gonna give us the CTA with the different states. So if I press Command Enter and you see it when I hover on it, it's gonna give us that, you know, fading effect. So the next step will be to take this and copy it, just pressing Option, and then we're gonna click this here, and instead of getting touch, change it to contact us, and then we just, you know, align it to the center of the elements, and then we have our two of our call to actions. And I need to add a arrow for this, and I'm gonna select here an arrow that we can use. This is not sponsor or anything. I'm just gonna arrow, and I'm gonna take this, and I'm gonna place an arrow right here. I'm gonna move it a little. We're gonna take this arrow that we have right here, and we're gonna place it right next to learn more underneath it. I'm gonna change the color to that gray color that we were talking about. And the next final step will be to add a little bit of dimension to this. We can achieve that by simply creating some lights. What I'm gonna do with that is just, I'm gonna select this curve pen tool, and I'm just gonna create some shapes right here. So I'm gonna try to create some shapes right now. I'm gonna remove the border, I'm gonna create the fill, and I'm gonna change the, instead of solid color, we're gonna do a radial gradient, and we're gonna reshape this gradient to fill, to do the shape of the light, so it comes from the top, and then we just keep straight. Well, I think the best approach would be to move it like this and stretch it, and we're gonna change this to the same white color, but we're gonna reduce all the opacity, and we're gonna move the light all the way here, and we're gonna change the, instead of this, we're gonna click it. Instead of background blur, we're gonna do object blur, and we're gonna increase it by a little bit, and it looks awesome. We're just gonna change the mode to soft light, or maybe a little bit of a hard light. We're gonna reduce the opacity. We're gonna take this same shape, select it, and press Command C, Command V, and we're gonna just mirror it, put it in the other side, and reduce here. Instead of hard light, we're gonna soft light, and in the field, we're gonna select like a bluish tone, give a little bit more dimension to this. Okay, I'm gonna increase it a little bit more. I'll do hard light, I'm gonna reduce a little bit of opacity here. Take this shape, I'm gonna press an option, I'm gonna duplicate it right here, make it a little bigger, and put it right on top of here of this text right now in the middle. Let me just move it a little bit here. I'm trying to rotate it a little, okay, just to put it on top of the text. And here we have our trendy website style done in just a matter of minutes. If you feel like you learned something new about Adobe XD, just give it a like. That'll help me a lot. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you again in the next video.